What's that hat?
Oh, this hat? It's called Fashion Baby. Look it up.
Young Mark Watney, study astrobotany. I make hanging gardens and nobody can stop me. Let's grow plants in space.
Welcome to the Astrobotany Show. I'm your host, Kai Rasmussen, and today we'll be talking about one of the most important aspects of spaceflight plant biology. Where did the gravity go? Preface. I want to demonstrate something to you. So let's take Billy and planet Earth and go to the Astrobotany Table Mobile. Astronauts appear weightless in outer space. This is because when an object moves further and further from a large planetary body, the effect of gravity weakens. Even though the term zero gravity is commonly used, it's not entirely correct because gravity exerts forces on all objects in outer space. So the term that we will be using is microgravity. Even though you'll commonly hear people use the term zero gravity. This is one of those things that's kind of like, but most scientific papers I've seen use the term microgravity, and NASA actually uses it as well, so it's the term we'll be using on this show. Because at the Astrobotany Show, we're sticklers for science. It's clear to us that microgravity affects astronauts like Billy's health. It will affect almost every cell in Billy's body. There's loss of muscle mass, loss of bone density, vision impairment, changes in intracranial pressure, rapid changes in blood pressure, and the list goes on and on and on. Ouch. So we've kind of got an idea of how microgravity affects Billy here, but we're not interested in Billy. We're interested in plants. I think it would be a good idea to go over some of the basic plant anatomy and also some of their essential needs. You may not know this, but this is a plant. Most of you are already probably familiar with what a plant needs, but I'll just review it really quickly. Needs water. Plants need nutrients and lights. Generally, roots grow down so they can get this water and nutrients from the soil, and the shoots grow up so the leaves can get to that sweet, sweet sunlight. So the question remains, how do plants know what direction to grow in? And more importantly, how do plants know what direction to grow in space? Tune in next week for this thrilling conclusion to the Astrobotany Gravitropism episode, part 2.
Let's grow plants in space.
Hey guys, welcome to the second Astrobotany item of the week, where we go over the Astrobotany item of the week. Alrighty. As you can see here, the item of the week is lights. No, wait, are lights. Yeah. Anyways, these lights are red and blue. I'm going to try to get it so the camera angle can kind of capture it. But they're patterned in such a way that it appears to give off purple light. And the reason for this is to get the most efficient growth out of plants, you want red and blue light. So naturally, in space where efficiency is the name of the game, we want purple light. Therefore, on the Veggie Growth Production System on the International Space Station, this is the type of light that you will expect to see. If you have any questions about astrobotany, feel free to let us know in the comments section below. Let's eat plants in space.